Let's find out together. We know that beer yeast is a facultative anaerobic microorganism. It grows and reproduces under aerobic conditions and alcoholic fermentation under anaerobic conditions. Beer fermentation requires a lot of yeast, and the yeast we put into the fermenter is far from enough. So it is necessary to pass enough oxygen to the wort before entering the fermentation stage. Let the yeast reproduce aerobically first to achieve the amount of yeast required for beer fermentation. In order to save costs, we generally use sterile air. We don't have to worry about oxygen damage to wort quality, because the yeast will run out of oxygen within a few hours. There are many aeration devices used for wort. The most commonly used is the Venturi tube. It is a pipe with large sections at both ends and a compressed middle section. It is generally connected to the outlet of the cold wort of the plate heat exchanger. During use, sterile air is introduced from the compression section. Disperse evenly in the high-speed flowing wort in the form of tiny bubbles. A vortex will be formed where the cross-section increases, forcing the wort to fully fuse with the air. The aerated wort enters the fermenter, and the yeast first performs aerobic reproduction. When the oxygen is used up, the yeast after reproduction will ferment the beer under anaerobic conditions. If you want to learn more about brewing beer, be sure to follow us.